There is a hole when we smile. I carry cadaver onto my mouth. It has been there for years. It stings when I breathe as when I speak out. I have been hiding the smell using mulled water, mints, or even drinking cheap vodka. Nothing helps to neutralize this odor. It is quite discreet at the first impression, but it gets deep, intense smell of rotting meat, bones, humidity, and vanilla lotion. The body stayed for years. When it was alive, it was an invaluable ally to attack any cheesecake, to champ any chewy meat fibers, and from time to time, to bite all my enemies. She was a warrior. In spring, I was forced to fly back to my home country. So I left Mon Ami in Brussels. The pain for missing her was insupportable. So the doctor told me that in order to continue alive, I had to kill her. I knew it was the only solution to continue. But how could I support to live without this ally? One night, while she was dreaming with a crunchy cinnamon cookies, I took a knife and betrayed her. I attacked vigorous to the tendon. I took off all the connection between us. Since then, all within us was dead. But I just could not support the idea of bodiless, so I preserved her voluptuous body in my mouth. During the summer, we meet in Montreal. We visit the best food venues in town. We got a lot of coffee and Portuguese pastries in Chez José. We visit the best bagels in towns. Both were surprised to find the difference with the New York style or even with the Polish original heritage. We tried some Indonesian rotis. Oh my god. They were paradise. They smelled juicy, fruitful, and sweet. Still warm lamb meat with vanilla and cloves evaporates from my plate. We ate all. Bite, bite, bite. Also that night, we visit the iconic meat spot, Schwarzes Lely. Best grassy chewy meat in my life. Everything was served in the proper American size proportion. Huge. The plate includes fries, pickles, and sauces. We met an Italian couple at line. We shared the table and passed the night talking and laughing. Me and Mon Ami, we enjoyed smiling even when a big hole was showing. Certain kind of connection happened in life. When everything is over, or when the absence of a symbolic being is just present. That warm night, I knew that they were not future together. The same year, I decided to move back to Brussels. I thought maybe we can say something from our relationship. But even a soup was a storm. The small details became bigger. If you add salt and pepper to the white bread, if you like pizza with pineapple, or if you ordered a shared mussels for three in the table, a piece of the body falls down from my mouth. One week, I just tried to eat fries for a month. They were tender enough and quite nutritious, but it didn't work out. They were sobrious for a taste, and Mon Ami couldn't handle out. The pain became bigger and bigger in my mouth. The constant idea that maybe inside of the rotting body would be a new, alive bacteria form, it intoxicated the whole environment. How to be the other in someone else's relationship? Who is the parasite? She couldn't invite the other to join, nor be in part of the system. One day, I visit the dentist, and I ask him to take off the body of Mon Ami. He acted in consequence. He broke inside my mouth and took the mole in pieces with his tweezers. My tongue still looked to her body, and there is nothing. Did I feel pain? Not really. I feel absence of her body, an intimate friend that stays much more in my memory than in my mouth.